Minasan konnichiwa, Otaku Oyaji da oginki desu ka? Hello everyone, this is Otaku Oyaji again, and today I am going to light up one set of Greenmax trains. It's the forecast set of the JR Kyushu BEC819 Dencha. I hope you enjoy it. Opening the box, we see that this forecast set is made up of all Santoshas or all front cars. This means that the layout of the interior would be identical. However, there's a slight difference in which that the first and the fourth cars, they have headlights, while the second and the third, they don't. Okay, but despite that, this means I can mass produce all of the interior lights for these cars. Okay, now let's have a look at the couplers. Greenmax usually come with Arnold couplers, and the way that they link the front cars is through their own, well, very basic and simple couplers. Now, I intend to replace all of these couplers with Kato couplers. They are in transit, so probably I will make another video when I'm swapping out the couplers, and probably I'll be running down my layout as well. Of the three non-Kato brands, Tomix, Greenmax, and Micro Ace, my preference is Greenmax when it comes to installing light. And the reason being, more working space. Okay, as you see on the chassis, I can either install the lights over there, alright, or I can install it at the back. So I have choice. And on top of that, there is more space at the back. So I have more working area. And I'm not forced to use jumper cables. Apart from the soldering iron, these are the components that I'll use to light up the 4-car Dencha. So first, we have the cool white LED strips cut into strips of 6 bulbs each. Then we also have the rolled copper wires into springs, which I will then cut and stretch into such as this. The bridge rectifiers, capacitors, nippers, modeling knife, and of course, my trusty Tamiya tweezer. The first thing I do is to do a test fit. Starting with the bridge rectifier, I identify the sides where the polarity symbols are, positive, negative, and then I bend the legs out. At this stage, I don't need to go for a total flat because I'm just doing a dry fit. And then after that, I align it with the LED strips. Now I invert it over, the positive side is at the bottom and the LED strip, its positive side is also at the bottom. And now I'm going to put it into the body of the car. Okay, after that, I will bring up the undercarriage and I align the two parts together to see if I can get a good contact. Okay, now if I were to just leave it like this, probably the springs would barely touch the edge. So what I would need to do here is to push it in. All right, probably I'll need to cut off the tips of the legs to make them fit better, and so they wouldn't touch the LED bulb. Okay, the good news is that I don't need to use any jumper wires. Even though I said I would mass produce all four lights, I will always completely light up one car. Okay, this is to ensure that the parts all fit. I don't need to make any last minute adjustments. Alright, first I'm gonna trim off the legs like so. And now it is confirmed that they would not touch the LED bulbs. I cut and stretch two copper coils into equal lengths, like so. And then I slide them onto the legs of the bridge rectifier, the side without polarity symbols. Next, I solder the bridge rectifier to the copper coils. Now the idea is to let the solder flow into the cavities, similar to pouring concrete into a pipe. Now I solder the bridge rectifier to the LED strip. First, I solder one of the contact points, and then I solder one leg of the bridge rectifier to the LED strip. If you're a minor, please enlist the help of an adult, because this can get dangerous. You could burn yourself, and contrary to popular belief, masculinity is not defined by number of scars. The last component is the capacitor. So like the bridge rectifier, I solder one connecting side first, and then after that I solder in the capacitor. Doesn't seem to connect. A bit more solder and that's it. Right, to ensure that the capacitor is flush against the LED strip, I press it down with my Tamiya tweezer and then apply solder again. And we're done. One pleasant thing I discovered about this set is this groove in the roof. And the LED strip fits perfectly into that groove. Perfectly. So all I need to do is to just stick it on directly. That's it. There's a small little indentation in one of the selections, and I just reinforced that with a bit of double-sided tape. But otherwise, it's a perfect fit. Fits like a glove. Right, so now I will just assemble the trains and test them out. All cars have been fitted with lights, and now we're gonna test to see if they work properly. So this is car number one. Front direction and reverse direction. Okay, so car one is good. Car number two, forward direction. Remember that two and three, they don't have any headlights or tail lights. And reverse direction. So car two is good. Connection, yeah, it's pretty decent. Car number three, the motor car. All right, front direction. I'm gonna go slow. Whoa, hang on, what happened to the lights? Okay, yeah, the engine will move before the lights come on. Okay, fine, the engine is really that powerful now. Alright, so just to show how well this thing will run. Oops, okay, I derailed it a little bit. Let's put it back, okay. Let's go reverse and yep, okay, yep. Front, okay, good, lights are good. And now for the fourth car. Actually, I had a little bit of a problem with this car. I could get the lights to turn on, but I couldn't get the front lights to come on. So at first I thought that, you know, there's a fault with the lights. I tried to test the coils and everything, and it worked fine. Turns out it was just a bad contact on the inside. Once I used isopropyl alcohol, well, you can see it was fine now. Alright, so that's it. I just lit up the four car set, and once I can get the couplers, I'll do a video on that and probably run it on my layout. Hope you will enjoy that. Yeah, so until next time, stay safe, stay blessed. Matane!